Cloud service providers have to be transparent and accountable for their services, including notification requirements and independent data security audits. Regulation or not regulation, this has been very much controversial also in the workshops. The answer to this question is do something. As a minimum about security, privacy, interoperability, openness, and competition. An important security concern relates to the lower threshold of protection for undisclosed personal data in the cloud against, for example, access by law enforcement, which prevails in a number of European countries and also in the United States. Because the data is stored by a third party, law enforcement agencies have easier means to access this data. It is important to change this paradigm because data in the cloud should be protected by the same safeguards against public and private interference as is data today on our desks or on our hard drive. A next issue is portability and interoperability, which is key to prevent users from being locked in with a given cloud service provider and to enable them to migrate with their records to another service provider. Regulation of these issues will be instrumental to keep the market open and to foster competition among providers. Consumer protection is also indispensable, as we heard already in the case of a bankruptcy, so that users can nevertheless access and retrieve their files. Whereas business consumers can negotiate the terms and conditions as well as the service level agreement with the cloud service providers, many consumers will be confronted with standard terms and conditions of service. For example, waiving liability.
Can we wait a little bit? It seems to be the case we have a problem with the audio for this scribe.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Do we have audio to this scribe?
And to be able to migrate. Whereas
can you hear us now? Can the scribe hear us? Yeah. Good, thank you. Please continue.
Business customers can negotiate terms and conditions as well as service level agreements. Consumers need protection from unfair commercial practices because they will be confronted with standard terms and conditions of service. So examples of such unfair commercial practices would be that the cloud service provider is changing subsequently the terms and conditions of a contract, or that in the contract the liability is waived for the service provider, which would be unfair, as we agree. Another major concern is that future business models may rely on the use of personal data of consumers of cloud services for advertisement or behavioral targeting. It is problematic when consumers' consent to the secondary use of their personal data is almost automatically generated when they are signing up for such services. And cloud services or remote hosting of files is not available on a standalone basis without committing to share the data. Indeed, regulation and common standards for these important issues will be needed in addition to working towards international harmonization with all stakeholders, which may take longer, but its need is compelling. I'm looking forward to our discussion about public policy pertaining to cloud services and the consumer protection issues here.